Bhagavad Gita, 4th chapter, 10th shloka. Sri Krishna tells to Arjuna, Vitaraga bhaya krodha, manmaya mam upashritaha, bahavo jnana tapasa, puta madbhava magataha. Vita, transcending, raga, attachment, includes aversion, bhaya, fear, krodha, anger, manmaya. One who comes in my path, mam upashritaha, one who is dependent on me. Bahavo jnana tapasa puta, becoming puta, purified by much of austerities of knowledge, jnana tapasa, austerities of all knowledge, madbhavam agataha, attains to my bhava or attains to my ethos. So the idea of attachment or the feeling of attachment is caused because of the ideas of doership and enjoyership, the ideas of I and mine, and because of that fear and anger are caused, which we see in the second chapter in the 62nd and 63rd verses of the second chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, where Sri Krishna tells how attachment to sense objects leads to complete destruction of a human being. And then here he says how we can get rid of these attachments by first following the path of Lord, Manmaya. That means one has to be always immersed in the idea that everything is divine and everything leads to that divine principle. Manmaya, mam upashritaha, and one is always dependent on God. One, as we see in the 12th chapter, which talks about bhakti yoga, one does not start any undertaking, one does not have any resolve of one's own, but is completely dependent on God. And how, is there any practice, is there any technique to achieve this? Bahavaha jnana tapasa. That means many. Bahavaha means many. Or in this context, much. Lot of austerities of knowledge. So, puta, one person becomes purified by the austerities of knowledge. Now, how does one become purified by austerities of knowledge? Constant vigilance, alertness of mind, constant discernment. Viveka, nitya, anitya, vastu, viveka. What is real, what is unreal. So you constantly discern, you discriminate. You say, this is not real, I don't need this. And so that you do at the level of the mind. So you constantly discriminate. That is jnana tapas. Tapas, tapa word means heat. So we generate heat when we try to go against the sense organs. And that is why it is called tapasya. So, jnana tapasa puta, being purified by much of austerity of jnana. That we can do in many ways. First way is, always think of things which will remind you of God or remind you of your true nature. So that is one thing. Instead of thinking negative thoughts, instead of thinking thoughts which will take you away from God, instead of thinking of this world, money, etc., instead of thinking of ideas of lust and greed, we should think of ideas which will take away our mind from lust and greed and take it towards God or divine principle, which is that you are not the body, you are not the mind, etc. You are either the child of God or you are Brahman, Atman, etc. So that is one tapasya, jnana tapasa. And also not to allow negative thoughts to come into your mind. Not to allow thoughts which take you away from God to come into your mind. Do not allow them. So you don't allow such thoughts, and then you become purified. So how do you become purified? If you don't have desires, then you are purified. So why you should not have desires? Because having desires will only lead you away from God. It will only lead you towards suffering. What kind of suffering? Desire always brings suffering, because the idea of desire, when you have desire, how will you fulfill your desire? With the idea of I and mine. Without the idea of I and mine, you cannot fulfill desires. So you have to fulfill desires by having this idea that I am the doer, I am the enjoyer. So if you have these ideas, only then you will be able to do what you want. And then these ideas, they strengthen your sense of ego. If they strengthen the sense of ego, then you, whatever action you do, that will bear results. And those results will become what is called karma, karma phala. Then you have to exhaust them. So that is why you have to go and uproot all desires. Remove the cause of this existence. That is why jnana tapasa. So tapa means heat. It can also mean fire. So tapasya is like fire. You burn a fire and you burn all those inherent tendencies or samskaras which are there in you. Okay. Which are there in you. You burn all those samskaras. When you burn the samskaras, then you need not take birth. That is the point. But what are people doing? They are always immersed in money. Even before death also, people are immersed in money. The thought of money. They always want money. They want to possess money. They want to spend money, etc. Because that is what they understand. So this jnana tapasa is very important. How? So this jnana tapasa reflects in your action, in your thought, and in your speech. So if a person is doing jnana tapasa, jnana tapasya, a person is doing jnana tapa, austerity of knowledge, how would that person speak? First of all, the person will speak only the truth. So that itself is a rarity. Nobody speaks truth. Everybody speaks anything but the truth. Okay. So you don't speak the truth. You speak only lie. So first you speak the truth. Only then you are a person who is performing austerity of knowledge. Okay. Second is, you will not speak anything which is taking you away from God. Taking you away from God. You will not speak anything which will take you away from God. So that is also not possible for most people, because most people don't know what is God. If you ask somebody what is God, they will say, what is the rate of God? What is its price? Kilo? 1 kilo, how much, etc. That is the idea people have. But if you tell a person you are stupid, that's all. That person will immediately get angry. Do you know who I am? So everybody will become ash. Even though you think you are intelligent, etc., you are going to become ash, or you are going to become skeleton. So that we don't remember. This is the second thing, that you will always speak only things which will take you towards God or which will be positive. Third thing is, you will never speak ill of anyone. You will never speak ill of anyone. So even if you speak something, you are telling something critical of people, it is more in a sorry tone, that oh, unfortunate that this is like that. But when we talk generally about somebody, ill of somebody, it is not because we are sorry, it is because we are happy. We are happy that person is like this. That is why in Bengali we say paraninda paracharcha. So means you want to talk about somebody, you want to insult somebody, you want to discuss about somebody because you are happy. You see, that person, he has no money, it is good. Because that fellow is like that, it is good, like that. You might not always say it is good or something, but secretly in your mind you are happy. And the person who is listening is also very happy. That is why this kind of backbiting, etc., goes on. So a person who does tapasya or austerities of knowledge will never do this, because it is waste of time, first of all. And it is negative thoughts going, it is all negativity going into somebody's mind. And a person will do what is called swadhyaya. If you want to do tapasya of knowledge, jnana tapas, you will do swadhyaya. What is swadhyaya? Swadhyaya is very simple. Literal meaning of swadhyaya is sva adhyaya. Means one who studies about one's own basis. One's own basis. Sva means one's own, oneself. Basis, swadhyaya. So one studies about one's own basis. What am I? Who am I? What is my nature, etc. That you can do by studying scriptures and also teachings of great people who have realized God. Or also you can just meditate. So meditation, contemplation also form part of swadhyaya. Swadhyaya does not mean only reading books. Contemplation, meditation, thinking. Who am I? What is my true nature? That is swadhyaya. So a person who is doing jnana tapasya will do swadhyaya. That person will do swadhyaya. And that person will be always trying to reach to some holistic idea about this universe, God and oneself. So a person who is doing austerity of knowledge, jnana tapasya, will not have a fragmented idea of the world. That person will not have a fragmented idea of the world. That person will go towards a unity of idea, a unity of concepts of this universe or God or oneself. That is why Sri Ramakrishna says in Bengali, Aker Gyan Gyan, Oneker Gyan Ogyan. The knowledge of unity is knowledge, and the knowledge of diversity or knowledge of many things is ignorance. So this jnana tapasya is very important. How, just like we have border police, we have people, army or police on the border. So we have this in India, we have this called Indo-Tibetan border police, or we have Sima Suraksha Bal, or we have border security force, etc. So they guard our borders. In some parts, in these Himalayan parts, it is the Indo-Tibetan border police. In other parts, it is BSF, etc. So they guard our borders and they ensure that, and of course there is army, they ensure that nobody comes in. Also, they ensure that nobody goes out also. Border cannot be breached. Nobody can cross the border, either from that side or from this side. That is the idea. So when you say that jnana, when Sri Krishna says bahavo jnana tapasa, that means it has to be done for a long time. And also it means that it has to be done in many ways. Not one method is not sufficient. You have to do, suppose there is a patient, and that patient is suffering from some illness, and lot of pain and lot of suffering is there. Lot of trouble is there for that patient. So what would doctors do? They will try all the methods available to them till the pain is subsided, till the suffering reduces. They will try all that is available to them. Everything they will try. And so that is what is also meant, one of the meanings of bhavaha means many. You have to try yena kena prakarena, by whatever method you have to try that you attain that blissful state which is your true nature. So in this jnana tapasa, just like that border security force or the Sima Suraksha Bal or Indo-Tibetan border police, that border patrol, you should have this idea that no positive thought should go out of your mind and no negative thought should come inside the mind. No positive thought should go outside your mind and no negative thought should come inside the mind. So what are positive thoughts? Positive thoughts are thoughts which will take you away from suffering. So if you think that I am pure, I am conscious, I am blissful, they are all positive thoughts. If you think I am the child of God, that is positive. If you think I am the child of Sri Ramakrishna, all these things are positive. If you think I am Atman Brahman, they are all positive. What are negative? I am this body, I am this mind. These are all negative thoughts. And because of that, so many other negative thoughts also come. Like, I have got this pain, my mind is not good, I am depressed, somebody has insulted me, etc. So all these negative thoughts have to be given up. And positive thoughts have to be brought in, or we have to ensure that we don't stop positive thoughts. This is the idea. Enthusiasm, etc. should be there.
What does it mean? No positive thoughts should go outside the mind.
Yeah, that means that, what does it mean when you say that no positive thought should go outside the mind? That means that you should not give up positive thoughts. Outside the mind means you should not leave your mind. Means that thought should be there in the mind. How does that thought leave the mind? Suppose you are enthusiastic. You want to do something. So at that level, positive thought is that you want to do something. Very good. Now, you see someone and you see that that person has tried doing the same thing which you are doing or you are going to do. And then you see that that person failed miserably. And then you think, no, I would not be able to do. Or you tell this to somebody and that person says, no, 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 it is not possible. You cannot do. You don't have the resources. You don't have the capability, etc. So this positive thought goes away from our mind. This positive thought we lose. We think, then it is not possible. And it is easy, very easy to lose positive thought. If you see how our mind is made, it is very easy to demolish a building. But it is difficult to construct a building. Why? Because everything that is made of matter, every material thing is like that. It is difficult comparatively to build it, easy to demolish it. If, for example, this table, it is very easy to demolish it. Within minutes it can be demolished. But to build the table, it will take a lot of time. So that is the characteristic of matter, and mind is matter. So mind, to bring in positive thought, it is very difficult. But it is very easy to bring in negative thoughts. Very easy to bring in negative thoughts. So, to tell someone and to convince someone that that person cannot do anything and is useless, one sentence is enough. Whole life, you would have heard from so many people that you can do everything. But somebody tells one sentence, that is enough for you to shatter all that and you will become depressed. Oh, that person told. Similarly, same person might have appreciated you so much, but once that person tells something, insults you, criticizes you, that only you, only that you will remember. Because that is the nature of anything which is made out of matter. Means anything that is made. Only things which are material are made. So all things which are made, it is difficult to make them and very difficult, very easy to destroy them. So that is what is the meaning of the sentence, that we should not allow anything to go outside positive. That means we should not give up. We should not give up positive thoughts. Why? Because it is very difficult to hold on to positive thoughts. Very difficult to hold on to positive. Very easy to hold on to negative thoughts. So, it is very easy on a hilltop to let water go away. See, water if you put on hill, it will flow down. But it is very difficult in a place which is below the sea level to remove water also. If there is little rainfall, there will be almost like flood, because the water will clog. It has nowhere to go down to. That is the idea. So something which is very high, it is very difficult to hold on. Sri Ramakrishna says, it is very difficult to stay in me. Of course, that he says in a different context. He stays in the context of, it is difficult to keep a high spiritual state all the time. It is very difficult. So he says, Saregama padani, padani. So that it is very difficult to stay in ni. That high note, to hold on to that high note, it is very difficult. So that is why we should ensure that positive thoughts don't go away out of our mind and negative thoughts don't come. So jnana tapasya. So these, all these things one should do, and only then that is tapasya of jnana. Now what is jnana? Jnana basically is knowledge. But are we talking about knowledge of material or empirical things, which is called aparavidya? Aparavidya means knowledge of empirical things, like knowledge of physics, biochemistry, quantum physics or nuclear physics, etc. That kind of knowledge is called aparavidya. No, we are not talking about aparavidya. We are talking about paravidya. What is paravidya? Paravidya is the knowledge of one's true nature. Paravidya is the knowledge of one's true nature, one's own nature. And that knowledge, that I am God, I am I am God, I am Brahman, or I am child of God, etc. That knowledge is called paravidya. That is the knowledge of the ultimate reality. And whatever helps us to attain that knowledge is called jnana tapas. Means tapasya, austerity, that helps us to attain that knowledge is called jnana tapas. And that is why, what will it lead to? It will lead to the purification of mind. Puta means after getting purified. What will get purified? Not the body. Body can never get purified. Body can never get purified because body is nothing but dustbin. Body is only dustbin. So they say beauty is skin deep. It is true. Because if you cut your skin, only foul smell will come. Bad smell will come. Inside everything is, food goes up to here and comes out bad. So whatever is there in the body is all impure. There is nothing pure in body. So what is going to be purified? Our mind is going to be purified. Mind is there on top of all senses. Without mind, no sense organ can operate. So if you see something, your mind, if it is not there, you cannot register what you have seen. If you hear something, if your mind is not there, you cannot register what you have heard. So Puta means, now here, purified. What will get purified? Your true nature is always pure. Atman is always pure. So what is going to get purified? Only the curtain is going to get purified. The curtain is this avidya, ignorance. That is the curtain. So your true nature is like a sun. It is always bright, brilliant. But there is a curtain. There is a covering. And that covering is of ignorance. And that ignorance is through mind. That will get purified. So automatically you will be. So the curtain, now there is suppose a curtain which will completely cover sun. Completely blind it will make. And then slowly that curtain is made thinner and thinner and thinner. And that veil or curtain will become transparent. So there will be no, there will be some avidya. But through that also you can see. So your mind will become pure. And again, how does mind become pure? By removing all desires. If you don't have any desires, only then mind will become pure. So that is why. And once that happens, madbhavam agataha, they attain to me. They reach me. That is the idea. So Sri Krishna says, once your mind is pure, purified, you will attain to me. So this is jnana tapasya, which is very important, and this everyone can do or should do to get to that blissful state. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat.